So I got a puncture on my front tire. So in today's video, I'm gonna show you guys how to fix a puncture. So wait and watch the video and learn how to do it yourself. As you guys can see, my front tire is completely flat. So to repair this puncture, we need to have few things. We need to have a puncture kit like this. So let me show you guys what's inside it. So here we have a glue and a tire opening tool like this, and we have a sandpaper and some patches. So if you guys don't have a puncture kit like this, what you guys can do is you guys can use a adhesive like this and a screwdriver for opening the tire, and you guys can cut out a small portion of your old worn out tube and make sure to cut this thing out of a old tube in a circular shape, because it's better to use a circular shape for a patching purpose. So that's all you need. So if you have a puncture kit, then use this, and if you don't, then use these things. So I'll keep these things aside. I'll fix my tire using this puncture kit. And one more thing that we'll need is a bucket of water to check where are the bubbles coming from. So that's all we need. So to take out the tire from my cycle, what we have to do is we have to place the cycle upside down, and then we have to come here and pull this thing like this, and we have to unscrew this thing. And after doing this, what we have to do is we have to release this brake like this, and then we can pull the tire out after completely unscrewing this. So it should come like this. So after taking off the tire from my cycle, we have to place this thing over here, and we have to take this tool and start opening up the tire. So what we have to do is we have to insert this thing like this, and then we have to open the tire up like this, as you guys can see. So we have to entirely do this. So I'll just do that. And so I have opened the tire entirely, so it will look like this. So after opening up the tire, we have to unscrew these things. We have to unscrew this nut, and then we can push this valve down and then take out the tube. So what we have to do is we have to insert our finger like this and push this thing down, and after pushing this thing down, we'll be able to take the tube out like this. So I'll just take the tube out. After removing the tube from the tire, what we have to do is we have to fill some air in the tube using a pumper. So I have filled this tube up with air. So what I will do is I will now take this tube and I will put this tube here in the water. So I'll just rotate this tube and I'll look for any bubbles. So I think I found it. So as you guys can see, the bubbles are coming right over here, right over there. I hope it is visible. So here is the puncture. So I'll press my thumb over there and I'll take it out, and I think here is the puncture. Yes, this is the punctured area. So I'll just go through the entire tube and I'll see if there are any other punctures apart from that one. Sometimes you can get two or three punctures at the same time. So I don't think there are any other punctures apart from that single one, but I'll just go through it and I'll check if there are any other punctures. So I checked my entire tube. I did not find any other puncture apart from that single puncture that I found. So it is right over here. The puncture. I'll take this sandpaper and then I'll just simply remove the dirt and the outer layer of the rubber of the punctured area, because it will help the patch stick more strongly. So sanding is a very important part, don't skip this. So I'll just do that. It started raining outside, so I just came inside my room. So as you guys can see, this is the puncture. So I just sanded down this area. So what we have to do now is we have to take the glue, and we have to apply some glue on this punctured area. So I'll just do that. So take this thing and apply a little bit of glue. So you just need a little bit of glue like this. So after having the glue on the spot, what you have to do is you have to spread this glue with your thumb in a circular motion and make a thin layer of glue over the buffed area. That so after doing this, what we have to do is we have to wait and let this thing dry. We have to wait for around 20 to 30 seconds, so it will dry up fairly. It will not be liquidy, but it will not dry up completely. So after that, what we have to take a patch like this and apply this patch on the affected area, so the patch will be fixed. So I'll just let it dry and then I'll show you guys how to apply this patch on the affected area. So the area that dried up fairly well. So now what I have to do is I have to take this patch and I have to place this thing over the affected area, and then I have to just press this thing down and let it stick to the tube properly, and then I can put this tube back on my cycle. Also, before putting the tube inside this tire, use your hand and insert it underneath the tire and check if there are any nails which is stuck inside the tire or not, because if there are any nails which is stuck, then you'll insert the tube and it will puncture again. So make sure that there aren't any nails or anything which can puncture the tube again. So just check that out. So if you find some nail or something like that, then take it out and then place the tube inside. So after inserting the tube inside the tire, you have to use this nut and tighten this nut up so the tube gets secure. And then squeeze this tire inside. So just squeeze this thing inside and then fill up the tire with air and put the tire back onto the cycle. So I'll end my video over here. I hope you guys learned how to fix a punctured tire, and if you guys liked my video, then do like my video and also subscribe to my YouTube channel, and also watch this previous videos that I have on my channel, and stay tuned for more videos and subscribe to my channel, and also hit the bell notification so that you get notified whenever I upload a new video.